Arrange the following terms in the correct developmental sequence: pollen grain, sporogenous tissue, microspore tetrad, pollen mother cell, male gametes. Now here there are different kinds of cells. Now we need to arrange the cells in a particular order in which it is formed. So here we can see the entire process of microsporogenesis and formation of the male gamete. Now the microsporogenesis occurs in the pollen sac. It forms from the microsporocyte, which is diploid in nature. This undergoes meiotic division, giving rise to 4 microspore. Each microspore is functional. They undergo mitotic division and give rise to male gametophyte. So now the same event, these two events, that is gametogenesis and formation of spore. So that is sporogenesis. We have to arrange them in a sequential order. So first it is the sporogenous tissue, which are present in the pollen sac. Now they are the pollen mother cells, which give rise to microspore tetrad by the process of microsporogenesis. Now this microspore, which develops into the pollen grain, and this pollen grains will give rise to the male gamete. So pollen grains are nothing but the male gametophyte, and they will undergo mitotic division, giving rise to the male gamete. Now inside this pollen grain there would be two types of cells: vegetative cell and generative cell. Vegetative cells will give rise to the pollen tube, and generative cell will give rise to the male gametes. So this would be the correct sequence: sporogenous tissue, pollen mother cell, microspore tetrad, pollen grain, and male gametes.